Finally, Seba says, I'm addicted to listening to songs and I know music is haram, but I'm unable to quit. Kindly give me some practical guidance or guidelines to quit listening to music. Usually, it is quite difficult to give practical guidelines when you know something is haram and you're still adamant to do it. Because the best motivation that drives us is the fear of Allah. The best motivation that helps us is to know that Allah is hearing all what we hear, seeing all what we do. And this throws fear in our hearts from Allah Azza wa Jal. So if a person fails to pay attention to all of this, fails to see the harm such music, such songs and lyrics are doing to him, and yet he still wants practical guidelines, I'm afraid that this is not that easy, because it's a way of life. Do you remember the hadith of the man who killed 99 souls? And when he asked a monk how to repent, the monk told him off and said, there is no repentance for you. You killed 99. So he killed him and finished 100. This man went to a scholar and he asked him how to repent. And the scholar told him, no one can prevent you from repenting, but you are in an environment, you're in a village or city that is corrupt, and you will always fall into sin as long as you remain where you are. You have to relocate to another town where there are lots of righteous practicing Muslims. You can worship Allah with them, you can repent, and you can set your things straight. So this is the ultimate way of repentance for those who cannot quit a habit or quit a sin. You need to change your environment. If you go to your home, you will find that everything in your home is focused and revolving around music. All the DVDs, all the loudspeakers, synthesizers or equalizers or whatever they call them, and your whole home is set up to listen to music. If you go to your car, you're going to find the same setup there. And you would find that you don't have time throughout the day to reflect on what you had done yesterday and what you're doing today and what you will do tomorrow. Because if you have 15 minutes or 30 minutes a day just doing nothing, reading nothing, listening to nothing, watching nothing, just contemplating and thinking, you'll feel crazy. Because shaitan will be on your case, telling you that this is not acceptable in his book. You have to focus on distracting yourself from thinking about what benefits you at the side of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So you need to change your environment. Look at your friends. Look at your mailing list. Look at your social media. You'll find that it all revolves around the top 10, the billboards. It revolves around celebrity news, ET, etc. All of this shows how addicted you are to the system. And you can't get out of this vicious loop unless you change your environment. And this requires that you begin drastically to get rid of all of these equipment and things that tie you up to your past and sins, to pick up righteous practicing Muslims to hang out with 24/7, to delete all of your social media accounts totally, because they will inevitably get you back to what you're trying to quit from, to start memorizing the Quran, attending circles of knowledge, watching religiously and academically, lectures and conferences and seminars and taking notes, watching everything that you can do so that you will learn your religion. Offering tahajjud, night prayer, occupying your time with dhikr. Whenever a song comes and you want to chant with it, no music, nothing, just you want to recall the lyrics, say instead, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. And this has immense and huge reward for you. And if you manage to do this, Allah Azza wa Jal will help you with the grace of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.